want to go on my lap now? Really? I love my cat, but I don't like the cat hair. Well, hello my lovely nestlings and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 44 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today I'm trying out the Anastasia Beverly Hills Eye Primer. So yeah, I actually thought that it was Annette's fault from Annette's Makeup Corner, but it's not because she does not like this primer. I know that Anki is raving about this one. So yeah, I'm going to try it today as well. And I thought let's try it with the Amrissi from ABH. I did do my brows already and that is the only thing. Yeah, and primer and skincare. I want to say sunscreen, that's also underneath, but yeah. So let's try it. And where are my brushes? My brushes are here in front of me, so that is good. So yeah, and I know that some of you have requested me to use the blue out of this palette. So I thought, let's do that today. So I'm going to kind of play here with the orangey browns a bit. And then probably with these and then the blue. And while I'm doing that, I'm going to try out the ABH primer. So it's... okay, it's a squeezy tube. That's okay. That I don't mind that. I thought it was a with a doe foot, but it's not. This is how many mils? Seven mils. I heard a weird noise. It's probably my cat. It kind of sounded like a, what's it called again, a seagull. I don't know. Let's just kind of do it like I usually do it. So, it's already just a tiny bit. Oh, it's pretty runny. So that's kind of here a bit, here a bit. Ah, yeah, if you hear something, it's the cat. I don't want too much, so I'm actually removing the rest on the back of my hand. So I can kind of do this a bit. Now, I don't use a lot of eye primer. Just so you know, and I also usually do not set it. And then I tap over it with my finger. Kind of feels like my MAC Paint Pot. That, yeah, I have a shitload of, but because I went cruelty free, I don't really know what to do with it. Maybe I can give it away to someone. It has been used, but only with a brush, so yeah. Okay. I do also want it underneath my eye, so I'm grabbing a little bit that I had on my hand. And the brush I'm using is one from Real Techniques, I believe. I don't know. What's it called? Yeah, a Real Techniques brush. I don't know. It's an eye set and then the bigger one. I don't like these for eyeshadow at all. But for primer, they are okay. Okay, so that's that. So let me grab a little bit of coffee. Let the cat in so that it can kind of sit a little. Well, hello cat. Is this handy? Do you want to go on my lap now? Really? You would think that I know better by now. Well, okay. Say hello to the people then, cat. Come here. Say hello to the people. Hello, people. Look, there. There. No? Oh. Oh. Okay, go away. I'm sorry, I don't have a box anymore here, no. Okay. Yeah, it has a little time to sit, so I am going to start with the first shade and the first brush. Let me grab you, because why not? I am going to start with... let's start with the color 1988. Hair, yeah. On the Sigma E33. I'm going to start in the outer corner. I love my cat, but I don't like the cat hair. So it seems to be gripping the color very, very nicely. Now this is a very light primer, but as you see, even though it is... maybe you can see on the back of my hand. I don't know if you can though. pretty light for me. If you blend it out and don't use a lot, you do get that light base. Now, if you are darker than me, what you can do is stop in the crease, basically, and then tap it out a little bit and maybe get a little bit of your concealer to blend the two together a bit more, so that it's not too pale for you. The lighter the base, though, color-wise, the more your eyeshadows will pop. So that is that. But as you see, it's not white. And I have seen people use this, put a shitload on, and then they have a white eye. And that is not the purpose of a primer. Just saying. Going to work it a little bit forward, I think. Okay, a little bit more. I don't want this to be a complicated eye look today. And again, I've said that a million times. And then stuff happens. Me. So far, it is creasing a tiny, tiny bit. But that is also not really weird for me. You know, my eyes are 43, I want to say. 44. No, I was... Yeah, my eyelids came later. It doesn't... I know. It blends out very, very nicely. There is no patchiness, and when I used this shade with my Kiko Milano primer, it got a bit patchy the more that I blended it, and this just blends away very, well, nicely, actually. Okay. And what you want in an eye primer is a kind of a dryness. That is what I had. That's, for instance, the MAC Paint Pot is a pretty dry formula. The Smashbox lid primer is a dry formula. I wasn't really used to that, but it is better. If you feel like it dries out your eyelids, use less. Especially with eye primer, sometimes less is more. And if you feel like your eyeshadow is splotchy, it could very well be that... It could be the brushes, it could be your application. Yes, it could be the eyeshadow, but it could also be your primer. I've noticed that if I put too much eye primer on, especially with, for instance, yellows or with pastel shades, it really, it's almost crusty looking. So if you have that, try less eye primer next time. Oh, I love this brush. This is from the Sigma Eye Blend set. That video is online already, and I know that everyone keeps saying it, brushes make all the difference, and I was like, yeah, sure, but why do you need expensive brushes? Well, sometimes you just need expensive brushes. Let's deepen it up a little bit. I actually wanted to use the orangey one as well, didn't I? Yeah, I did. So let's clean the brush. I don't think there is a lot of difference between New Yorker and OG though. I don't know. Let's go to OG because it seems to be a little bit lighter. It's going to go in the beginning of my eye. I'm just using the same brush. I just cleaned it on the towel that I have here. Okay, I'm switching to the E42. I'm going to go to the color called... I think I'm going to go to the black called BK. I'm going to use it to deepen up the outer corner. But so far, blending wise, it blends very, very nicely. Wow, they are having a... Oh. I don't know if the camera picks it up, but the magpies are having a discussion outside. It's probably a cat in the area, one of their young on the ground, and then a cat in the area. That's usually kind of the noise that they are making then. I have a problem here in this corner with shadow sticking sometimes. Which kind of happened the last time that I used this palette. It's not that way now. I think that is about it. Now I'm going to grab my NYX Glitter Primer. By the way, NYX also has a pigment primer. If any of you have used that, let me know, because I'm actually really, really curious. Let's grab the... No, I had a brush for that I actually like to use. The... What was it? The E27 I like to use for this. Basically, I'm just going to paint a little bit of the eye. What's it called again? Glitter primer on my eye. Wow, they are having a field day. Let it sit for just a second, so I can basically do the other eye too. And I use the, I don't know if you can see it, probably not, but I use the tiniest amount. Again, especially with products like this, and then especially if your eyes are a little bit older, or I don't know, hooded, you know, deep set, you see that, I don't know, can you see that fold there on my eye? Stuff like that, if I use too much primer, it kind of creases there, or it sticks together there. I'm looking down very sexily because otherwise it kind of creases. Then I'm going to go into the shade called, actually the shade Anastasia is my favorite, but I'm going to go in the shade called Leo the Blue because y'all wanted me to. So I'm basically cleaning the brush that I have used a tiny bit on the towel because it does not really matter. I'm going to go into the shade called Dragon. And it's going to go in my inner corner part eye area. Oh, I actually like that. So let's place a bit first. I'm going to blend a bit. Just on the edge here. And apparently I'm pulling it a little bit more in. Because that's how I roll sometimes. Apparently, today is one of those days. Maybe this is not the right brush for what I'm doing, but I actually really like it for that purpose. Now I kind of need to think what I want underneath my eye. I do have a very, very nice, this is a dark teal. It could be too dark. No, that's very pretty. So let's put that there. I want a stiffer brush, so let's get my Morphe. Just want to blend it out a bit. Actually, I want to blow it out a lot, so I'm going to blend it down. Did I say the pencil? It's from Kiko Milano. It's a very nice pencil. Oh yeah, I like that. This is the intense color long lasting eyeliner with a smudger thingy that I could have used, but I always keep forgetting. Very nice pencils. I want the gold there as well, but I think I need a little bit of glitter primer, so I'm grabbing it on the back of my hand, just a tiny bit, with the Morphe E36 again. Just painting it on my eye. Then I'm going to go back in the shade called Dragon. Let's grab the Ofra All Lights highlighter thingy-majingy for the shade number 4, Rodeo Drive, which is this one. It's going to go in the inner corner, so I'm kind of cleaning my Morphe brush a bit because I'm using it anyway. Yeah, cool. I am going to finish off the eyes and the face and all that, liner lashes, the whole shebang, and then I will be back and I can kind of see how my eyeshadow held up, and I will give you my final first impression thoughts on the primer. Wow. Okay, I changed up my earrings, put on lippy. Well, basically you see the rest. I will mention the lippy. It is from Menagerie Cosmetics in the shade Leo, and I like it. It's actually the first time that I'm wearing it, and it's a nice thin formula. So we will see how I like it during the day. But the rest of my face, well, no, not the rest of my face. The rest of what I have on my face will be listed down in the description box in case you are wondering. Let's go back to the eye primer. I like the fact that it is a squeezy tube and not a doe foot. That is what I like, because I feel like I can better control what I use. And I actually think it is more hygienic as well, because I don't, you know, I don't know. I can use different ways of applying it. So yeah, I like it. It's actually quite a lot that you get. I paid about 15 euros for this. So yeah, if what I said in the beginning, if you don't use too much, you don't create a white layer because you don't need as much. You know, let me see how the eyeshadow held up. Very, very nicely actually. What I did notice with the ABH shadows, especially the dark ones, that they kinda, it is almost like they have an oiliness to them. So when I blend them out, they get kinda shiny, and they tend to go away. Like for instance, I have in summertime when I am warm and a little bit more sweaty, you kind of sweat off your eyeshadow, you know? Maybe I'm alone in that, or maybe it was the wrong eye primer that I used, because now I still have a little bit of that shininess, but I feel like it is on more securely. It did not blend out patchy, and for that I am very happy. So far I like it. It is not really creasing on me. So yeah, granted, it was the first time that I used it. I will use it underneath other shadows as well. I do like the fact that it has kind of a base tint to it. I prefer that. I can understand that if you are darker than me, a little bit or maybe a lot, you will have, I don't know, maybe a problem with this. But as I said in the beginning, if you want shadows to really pop, you need an as light as base as possible. I don't know if that is correct English, but I hope you understand what I mean. And again, if you don't overuse it, it is not that you have a white... You don't need to do P. Louise thingies, you know? Let's just say that you don't need a lot. It's just an extra layer of stuff on your eyelids that can create texture and move. Just make sure that it is the right amount. So experiment a little bit with that and tap it out. So basically maybe stop here in your crease and then tap it out a little bit. So blend it up, you know, maybe mix it a little bit with your concealer. Just make sure that it is not too wet. Just tap it out. Usually we want the most stickiness here so that it stays the longest, you know, or at least for me in the crease is where my shadows tend to rub off the fastest. So yeah, I think that is it. So far I like it, and I will give you my final thoughts in my review roundup. I will probably upload that late June, early July, so that I have had time to try everything out really. And then I will give you my condensed thoughts in a video. For now, this was it. I like it. That's the first impression. If you have this one, let me know down below how you like it. Let me know if you don't like it, let me know why, and maybe how you use it. You know, maybe you have a preferred way of using this primer. Let me know down below in the comment section. For now, I am going to shut up because I need to go to work. It's been a while since I went there, so I'm kind of nervous, but that's okay. I'll live, I hope. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. Stay safe, stay healthy, try to stay sane, and I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.